supposed to be taking a girls' trip 2 weeks prior to us meeting, and it was April of 2008. And lo and behold, there was a random snowstorm that happened in Memphis and Nashville area at the end of March, and it pushed our girls' trip 2 weeks out. So I guess it was kind of fate that it all happened, because had I come 2 weeks before, he was out of town. And yeah, we went to Tin Roof down in Nashville in Demumbrian, and it was a late night, and I had gone outside to make a phone call to my boyfriend at that time to come back to the table where this fella was sitting, and he wasn't there before, and he had just smart aleck comment after smart aleck comment, and to be honest, I thought he was a little bit annoying. But we somehow kidnapped him, and he stayed at my friend's house. Nothing happened, but the next morning I noticed that he was really funny. And this was the day in MySpace. I left Nashville, go back to Memphis. We did not exchange numbers. I get back and I have a message on MySpace from David Nail.
It was one of my favorite lines. I said something along the lines of, did you show me everything, or is there more to see or more to learn? Mm-hmm. And I remember staring at it going, that ain't bad. That ain't bad. That might actually work. And literally within like an hour, I had not only a reply, but at the very end of it, it had her number. And I was like, wow, this is even easier than I thought.
And I think somehow in there I said, if I'm ever up in Nashville, here's my number. Like, you were going to know when I was going to be there next. But it wasn't the part.
You were going to make sure that I was aware, though.
That's true. But I did have my eye on Nashville moving here already. He just kind of sealed the deal.
I don't have the ring, but what I got's a whole lot better than all those fancy things.